No one in Chicago take him serious. I ain't gonna lie to you. He just came up out of nowhere, but he is raw as hell with rapping. But why is a grown-ass man going out their way to diss him? 757 Big Snoop is dissing Baby Chief Do It and Youngin' Ace. Now, I don't know who Big Snook is, but I have heard of 757. I'm finna play the video, but the reason why he dissing him is because he got Do It in his name and Youngin' Ace made a song Do It. If you try to make $750 a week, check out the bio.
Baby Chief Do It is a bitch. His ass not a Do It. He has not no Do It. He gotta change his name or his ass gotta pay the guys. If he don't pay us, we is coming to the birds. I'm letting motherfucker know that now. All that Baby Chief Do It shit, his ass gotta pay. You too, Youngin' Ace.
Now, this is a little zesty. Twin brothers going viral on social media for sharing the same woman. I ain't gonna cap to you, bro. Why would you want to share your girl with your twin brother? Like, it's cool to run a little train on a female with your brother or whatever, but you inside a whole relationship with a woman with your brother. So what, y'all sleep in the bed together, all three of y'all, with some shit? Like, how did this shit even work? And then I ain't gonna cap to you. I don't even wanna be with no woman that wanna do some shit like this. Like, if a woman be like, yeah, how about me and you get into a relationship and your brother get involved? What, shorty? You talking about me and my brother getting a relationship and share you? Shorty, you cooked. You cooked in the brain if you think that shit is okay. I ain't gonna lie to you. But for them two to be okay with this, I don't know, man. And the only reason I said that's zesty because why you want to share your girl with another dude? It don't matter if it's your brother. That shit's still another dude. All hope is not lost. You feel me? They still got some common sense. Three teams have refused to play San Jose State University volleyball team as it being reported that a member of the team is trans. We really shouldn't be talking about this shit for real. They are not women. So therefore, they should not be playing women's sports. They should be doing trans women's sports if they want to do sports. Or if they are trans woman, which was a man that's trying to be a woman, they should play a man sport. Because they was born a man, that's what you're supposed to play. You don't get to just be like, oh yeah, I'm a woman, so I get to play women's sports now. Hell no, that's unfair. Like, do trans not understand that even though they think that they is a woman, they is still built like a man and have benefits of a man that women don't have? And when it come to competition, that shit is unfair. Bro is the overlord in that bitch. They said bro is eating better behind the walls than most of us home and free. I ain't gonna lie, his ass got everything in that bitch. He literally prison rich. Like, he literally the richest man in his motherfucking prison. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. You got snacks like this, bro. You was the king up in that motherfucker. I ain't gonna lie to you. He really need to be smooth in that bitch. Someone backdoor his ass for all that shit. He got so much shit, he probably ain't gonna know some shit missing. Nah, they be taking that shit serious. That commissary like money up in there. They be counting everything. So he gonna know it's something missing. But I ain't gonna lie, I won't even want all that shit. I try to get that shit when I eat some of it, then get some more shit. Cause all that shit at one time is wild as hell. He just trying to flex in that bitch. But shit, he do got more food than me. I go look at my cabinets right now. I don't got no snacks like that. To be honest, I don't got no snacks. I just got some leftover Popeyes up in that motherfucker. Why do you want your man to look good in jail? Who is he trying to look good for in jail? It's a lot of questions that need to be answered. If I'm going to jail, the last thing I'm worried about is getting my hair done. If you trying to make $1,000 a week through your phone, check out the bio. Would y'all want to get y'all hair done before jail? Maybe I'm just tripping. Living forever, Mr. Beast found a way to do it through YouTube. He revealed that he got 15 YouTube videos filmed that he'll publish once he passed away to keep his channel alive. So basically, even with Mr. Beast gone and off this earth, y'all still gonna be getting Mr. Beast videos. That's real dedication, I ain't gonna lie to you. I wonder what those videos gonna be about though. Is it gonna be videos talking about how he feeling the days before he passed away? Like, or is it just gonna be regular ass content? He just gonna be posting them bitches like how them rappers be doing the shit when they pass away with them songs and albums and shit. And I ain't gonna cap, 15 videos ain't enough videos to keep his page alive forever, unless he plan to post like one video every motherfucking 2 to 3 years or some shit like that. The police would have been waiting outside if this was a man. Look what this lady do. I ain't gonna lie to you, I wouldn't be complaining if I was that kid, you feel me? I would have been turned up. But what's wrong is wrong. If they had R. Kelly doing his little freaky dance up in that motherfucker on the females, he would have got most definitely sent to jail. But I had double standards. Women can't do the same shit as men, and men can't do the same shit as women. So if a woman doing this shit on some high schoolers, I ain't really tripping. But if a man was doing this on some high school girls, oh yeah, send them to jail. Because why are you trying to do this, gang? Like, come on, bro. What is your problem? Mess with someone your age. I ain't saying it's right, but shit, if that was my son in the back right there, I wouldn't be tripping. I'd be like, go crazy, son. You going cool. And they smarter than we think. Elementary students weighs in on VP Kamala Harris and Donald Trump election.
What's the first word that pops into your head when you hear the name Kamala Harris?
Liar.
Before we continue, just remember, lots of these kids is just saying shit that they heard their family members say, and they just repeating that shit when someone asks them the question.
First word that pops into your head when you hear Donald Trump?
Pure evil.
Which one do you think is more selfish?
Like, selfish? Probably her.
Kamala Harris?
Yeah, because girls are a little bit dramatic sometimes.
And
I could tell she heavily influenced by her dad, because that sounds like some man shit to say.
And do you think that people in the United States are ready to have another 4 years of Donald Trump if he's reelected?
No.
Why not?
Because, like, I feel like all he does is, like, complain and, like, yell.
The researchers found that opinions of the candidates from these 10 and 11-year-olds spanned a spectrum as wide as America.
Donald Trump, he's given his life and his heart. She even shook hands with Mr. Trump to greet him before the debate, started the debate, which is pretty kind of when you're going against your opponent.
What the fuck is going on in Georgia? Police officer named Investigator of the Year was shot and unalived while breaking into his neighbor's home. And this is why I say you can't trust the police, because the police be doing the same fucked up shit as the motherfuckers they be locking up. It's crazy. He the motherfucker you supposed to call when someone breaking into your crib. And he the motherfucker that's breaking into your crib. I ain't gonna lie to you. But luckily someone had that blick up on him, so they was able to blow his ass down. Now what made him do this shit, I don't fucking know. But shit like this just proved my point on how you can't trust them motherfuckers at all. I ain't gonna lie to you. What the fuck, Kodak? What do you got going on, bro? What do you got going on, gang? That boy Kodak car caught on fire. They said it just caught on fire. I don't know how the motherfucker just caught on fire, but as you can see, that motherfucker on fire. But what I do know, if you're trying to make bread through your phone, check out the bio.
We was in flames. We was in motherfucking flames. We gotta repost this new story.
I think that's the only reason why he's walking around with a motherfucker. That's the only logical reason. Because if there ain't no music video prop, I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm gonna stay away from Kodak. Any motherfucker walking around with a katana like that, I'm scared of.